I think Happy Corbin is the luckiest man in WWE.
Why?
I would agree with that assessment. Let's talk about this, Cole. From riches to rags, back to riches. How can you not be inspired by Happy Corbin?
He doesn't have to rub it in our face.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Kansas City, weighing in at 275 pounds, Happy Corbin!
This story just pulls my heartstrings. It is great when good things happen to good people.
Good people? You think Happy Corbin's a good person? The amount of people he treats like absolute garbage?
Hey, Corey, did you get the invite?
I sure did. We
Me
are
you.
Hitting the town.
Go on, Corbin.
Graves, Happy Corbin.
I never got an invite, guys.
There's a reason for that.
Actually, probably a dozen.
I think someone's about to get flattened, guys.
And his opponent. From the land of the rising sun, weighing in at 558 pounds, Yokozuna!
Success in the sumo arena only topped by his WWE success, Yokozuna. This man once held the WWE title for nearly 300 days, and I think he could easily repeat that success again.
Man, look at the size of Yokozuna.
Even more impressive than his sheer size is his ability to move around the ring like no one else. A horrifying blend of size, speed, agility, and power. This superstar had better be prepared for Corbin's immediate onslaught. It only takes a second for Corbin to turn your lights out or toss you around the ring.
Set for action. Hopefully he realizes this match is no laughing matter.
Oh, come on, Cole. They say laughter's the best medicine, and Happy Corbin has never been healthier.
Well, that could all change here with this matchup. Corbin is a vicious competitor, but he's had issues with keeping his eye on the ball as of late.
And across the ring from him is none other than the legendary Yokozuna. We are in for a treat, Corey.
Size, aggression, and athleticism all rolled into one. Yokozuna is truly one of a kind. We might be in for a treat, Saxon, but that's because we're not the ones in there with him.
Ooh, right in the face.
What's the strategy got to be going up against Happy Corbin? Despite the moniker, he's definitely as angry as ever.
As much as it pains me to say it, sometimes Corbin's arrogance can get the better of him.
Corbin always thinks he's the smartest competitor in the ring, and on very rare occasions, he's not. So if you can be smarter than him, you can get the upper hand.
Oh, from the rope!
Oh! Ripped in the hard way.
That move had the amount of force akin to a natural disaster.
Now he's been put on the defensive.
Flapjack!
Gosh, landing face first.
And Corbin is being handled here.
And you gotta hand it to him.
Up high!
Corbin dodges that one.
Vicious right forearm.
And we might be about to go from commentators to participants in this one, fellas.
Punch across the cheek.
Corbin trying to spread his happiness to everybody. Come on, Cole, hop on the bandwagon. Saxton, go lay in front of the wagon.
STO!
This fight is going down right in front of our faces.
More up close and personal than I'd like to be. What are you guys thinking?
Obviously not about the ref's count, Cole.
He'll take things into the ring.
I don't know about you, Corey and Byron, but I'm so happy to once again walk with Elias.
Well, personally, I miss hearing Zeke speak.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 222 pounds.
What do I need to do to get this guy to stop playing music? Say on air that he's not Ezekiel?
Well, you should say that because it's the truth.
We are about to find out why WWE stands for Walk with Elias.
Yeah, because I'm about to walk to the concession stand.
See ya.
Enter the torture machine.
It's like Drew Gulak flipped a switch, and he's always on.
A man who loves competition, but loathes his opponents.
And his opponent, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 193 pounds, Drew Gulak!
Don't judge Gulak by his somewhat smaller build. This is a dangerous, dangerous individual.
No shortage of fight at all in Drew Gulak.
Drew Gulak has a distinctive reputation as a submission specialist.
An incredibly high in-ring IQ and raw determination possessed by Gulak.
Your opinion on Elias's musical talent aside, Corey, we can both agree on just how much of a physical threat Elias is from bell to bell.
And what can you say about Drew Gulak other than he's a man who has dedicated his entire life to mastering wrestling? He's a no-frills competitor who is all about substance in the ring.
Even I have to admit, Gulak's knowledge of grappling is staggering. But it's that incredible mind for wrestling that makes him a constant threat to any superstar that crosses his path.
The disdain it takes to repeatedly stomp someone like that.
Vicious knee drop.
As the wrist trapped, and now a series of...
Can he do it here? He's able to kick out before two.
Loose cover leads to a strong kick out. Oh, my goodness.
Just strike it at will.
Drew Gulak with power on point.
Yeah, Elias needs to figure things out quick.
He's getting a little battered now. And we know Elias can play a mean tune, but what does he have to do to take things to the next level tonight?
Elias is a powerful, perfect time to attack when his guard is down.
Oh, jab!
Gulak with a resolve in his eyes now. No thanks to the WWE Universe.
This is agonizing. The deathlock is in.
Gulak just rubbing it in right now.
Just pinning the arm down and then...
And a carefully measured into the cover.
And he kicks at it, too.
He really thought that was it.
Uh-oh. He can do it here. Kicks out at just one.
These men knew this match was going to be hard fought.
Okay, consider that a harsh lesson.
Oh, goodness, that looked bad.
A no-frills assault by Gulak. That's what a true master of his craft is capable of.
Hoping to end it here.
This is it.
And this one is over.
Here is your winner, Drew Gulak!
Wrestle perhaps the perfect match. Never any doubt in this win.
As always, Cole, you're more polite than I am, so I'll just say what we're all thinking. This was as one-sided as it gets.
6'4", over 550 pounds.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from the land of the rising sun, weighing in at 558 pounds, Yokozuna!
What makes Yokozuna so scary is his ability to use his massive frame or surprising agility to earn the win in any situation.
Well, that ability, Corey, has earned Yokozuna victories over all-time greats like Bret the Hitman Hart, the immortal Hulk Hogan, and The Undertaker.
No time to panic. You have to maintain focus on the sinister Finn Balor to have any chance in this match.
If you've got nervous butterflies, get rid of them now.
Here comes Finn Balor.
A man who has truly embraced his darkness and has seen success as a result.
And his opponent, representing the Judgment Day, from Bray, County Wicklow, Ireland, weighing in at 190 pounds, Finn Balor!
Well, Finn Balor is a true, fierce competitor who will beat down anyone in his path.
Balor has honed his skill set and turned his entire body into a weapon.
Hey, let's not forget, Balor is a very gifted technical wrestler.
Yeah, Balor also has a very nasty attitude.
Who are you to pass judgment on a member of the Judgment Day, Byron?
Look at the focus in Balor's eyes.
Yeah, Balor looks ready to clear the obstacle that awaits him.
Byron, I think Finn wants to do more than clear the obstacle. Finn looks ready to obliterate the obstacle.
Kicking things off in this one with Yokozuna, one of the first members of the legendary Anoa'i dynasty to really make a name for themselves here in WWE.
Yokozuna may have dabbled in cultures besides his own to sharpen his skills, but make no mistake, he is as double tough as anyone on the island and as agile as a guy half his size.
That's right, Corey. Truly one of the most unique athletes we've ever seen here in WWE.
And he's in for a battle against Finn Balor, a man whose focus has shifted more towards destruction and chaos these days.
You can't blame Balor for looking out for himself, Saxton. The Prince has traded benevolence for ruthlessness in order to take his career to the next level.
This one is headed outside, guys.
What a headbutt.
Vicious.
Oh, what a nasty knee lift.
Corey, we know that Finn Balor is only focused on winning, and by any means necessary. That seems like a quick way to get yourself disqualified in a match.
Balor has the experience and ring knowledge to know when the risk is worth it, Cole. If Balor can keep a level head in this match and bend the rules without breaking them, he should be in an advantageous position.
He'll head to the ring.
Yokozuna turning up the intimidation factor.
Finn turns it around.
And look at this now. Yes, applying the submission hold.
And he makes it to the ropes.
I knew he could.
Talk about dismantling your opponent.
Yokozuna turning his attention to the WWE Universe now.
Lands the elbow. Cover. Shoulders are down. And the referee stops the count before two.
Fighting hard to stay in this match.
Flapjack.
Hold on a second.
I was worried about this happening. And this superstar's waiting for him. Where's he at?
So hopefully this will be a short trip outside.
Oh God, that hurt.
Yokozuna gets reversed. And he slides him back to the mat. Outside the ring now.
Right to the kidneys from behind.
Big cat around the knees. That was an effective attack, guys.
Down to Bowden and a double axe handle smash.
Target in the arm now. And Finn heads him off at the pass. Goes under the ropes to get back inside. Oh, clothesline. Oh, double leg face buster.
Boom. Ooh, targeting the leg there. Oh, he gets what he deserves for all that gloating. Into the corner.
Dragging his opponent out of the corner and a thunderous headbutt from Yoko.
It is only going to get worse for the opponent of Yokozuna. From the middle rope.
Bonsai.
Is it enough? Is it enough for Yokozuna?
Makes a cover. Yokozuna scores a huge victory.
Here is your winner, Yokozuna!
And you can't ignore just how much the previous distraction shifted the tide of this match. Tried to stay vigilant the whole time, but it proved too much in the end.
Yeah, they put up a good fight, but you have to imagine her head was not in the right place after that distraction.
That's true, Saxton. It's hard to focus on just the match when there's an outside variable at play.